Hi guys, it is the 1st of January 2022, so I've decided to get out more this year, and I've decided to try and do the beaches of Kent. I've done a couple before, but I just want to have a walk around them. So today we're on Minster Leas on the Isle of Sheppy, so this is where it roughly starts. Beyond that is Sheerness, just in the distance. Over there is Barton's Point Coastal Park. It's got like a lake there, it's a miniature railway there somewhere. And you can walk across all them lands. It's quite nice, I've done a video on there before, you can check that out. So yeah, we're going to walk down, I'm going to walk along past them cars, onto the beach. And we'll walk along. Far as we can. So I'm going to make these beach videos like walk and talks. This may be a bit jumpy because this is a pebble and shingle beach and there's lots of people, so I'm going to stop talking every now and again. So let's get to the start then and I'll start the video proper. I'm going to try and do most of this video uncut. So this bit here, there's the Barton's Point Coastal Park, just over the back there where the Shelleys are. You can see that car driving down. This bit here, I'd say, is the start of Sheerness Promenade, maybe. So these bits here, these rocks, this breakwater, whatever it is, let's say this is the start of Minster Leas Beach. We go down now. That looks messy, doesn't it? Let's jump down. So we'll walk along. As I said, I'm probably going to stop talking every now and again because one, I want to take pictures, and two, I won't talk when people's around. I feel like a dork. See, the pebbles are quite wet, so obviously the tide's gone out recently, or however long it is. Don't know much about tides. Some old pipe there, look, with water coming out of it. This might be a long video because I don't know how long it takes me to walk along here. I'm going to walk down by the water. Not too far down though, because I don't want to get my trainers dirty. So yeah, as you can see, it's all shingle and pebbles, a little bit of sand underneath, but not up on the actual beach part. That's just all shingle. You can see sort of how far up the water goes by the way the pebbles are. Oh yeah, there's more water here. You have to excuse me if I sniff and cough. My immune system is crazy since I've been getting older. And whenever there's a cold wind, my nose runs. To be honest, this is a lot busier than I thought it would be. So when we come down to right there in the distance, there's this long, the bit that I first filmed on, it was like a little seawall sort of thing, but it's all parking up there. I didn't see anywhere you had to pay, but that might change when I get back and see a ticket on the window screen. Have a little walk by the river, seafront, and then I'll walk back up more into the pebbles. So you've only done that little bit. Hope it's not too jumpy for you. It's easier to walk on the sandy bit than what it is out actually on the pebbles. But there's lots of families out, dog walkers. Some people do some raft now. There's lots of fishermen along there I saw earlier. And up there is lots of campervans that look like they're there for a few hours or even probably all day. as we said before, around that corner of Sheerness, sort of over that way, is Minster. If you follow this right the way round, you'd bring you to lays down here, Sheerness Bay and that. And lays down is probably Sheppy's most popular beach, and also Sheerness because of the promenade. This one here, so it's more of a beach where people come to walk, do fishing and crabbing and whatever else they do. And it did say on the sign about windsurfers, so I think there's a lot of windsurfing goes on here. That's boiling for me, there's got to be cut. Guys or whatever they are, their wetsuits on. I don't know what that guy's got, I don't know if he's got fishing stuff or if he's got camera stuff. I don't know much about either, to be honest. Never fished, apart from nothing about remotes when I was younger. And the nearest I get to proper photography is taking pictures on my smartphone. There's all the cameras I said about. See, some of them might be fishermen, some might be here for the sea, like the water sports. Others may be just people into van life and that are just travelling the coast and more dog walking. Helicopter, something, oh, that's a plane. So the water obviously is Essex. I think he'd fish it there, so he's got a big net. It is the slight breaks in the camera, it's just where I'm either having a cook bait or wiping my nose. TMI. He's definitely dragging some net there, look. A lot of them definitely here for the day. Put all their little roof space up and chairs out, tables out. Dog with his ball. Everyone's having their nice strolls. I do feel a bit of an idiot sometimes walking up talking to myself. But chances are I'll never see these people again, so I shouldn't worry too much. Oh, litter. It's all the way along here you can park. My car's just over there. I walked, parked up and walked on to the end. Have a little walk on the stones. I don't know how far around we can get, we'll go as far as what I consider to be the beach. Beach is in that you can sit on, relax, enjoy the weather and the sea. If you've got cliffs above you with falling rocks, that's not really the kind of place I'm on about. Oh, so we're going to the stones, this is where it's new jumpy. There's loads of shells and that nice crunchy sound. And I know you want to see seashells and stones. So I thought, you know, doing these beach ones, it's not just more places of Kent, but it's also getting me out. And getting out is always good for your mind, body and soul. And when you're out sort of doing something like this, you forget about the minute problems. I mean, obviously the big problems are always in your head, but the small problems, like I've got work in a couple of days and stuff like that, that kind of upset you, get you down a bit, you know, after having the Christmas period holiday, getting back to normal. And of course with the virus situation, try and still keep the 2 metres, because not that I'm scared of the actual virus, it's more of, I'm self-employed, I can't afford to have the time off. And I also work with the general public, so if I do catch it, I really can't be going to work. It's all along here, all car parking, well my car's just up there, I can see my car. Quite a wide beach, as you can see the water sort of comes up to here. You can sort of tell by the seaweed and the way the stones are laid. But even if it comes out that far, it's still a bit of a beach up there. And yeah, to be honest, I think it's about 55 degrees today, which is good for a January. I mean, I wouldn't say I'm baking, but with my jacket on, I'm quite hot. How far we come? Well, you can't see the rocks where I started now. Looks like I scared everyone off. Everyone behind me's gone. I thought it would be interesting to do the beaches of Kent. I mean, I'm not going to do the whole coast of Kent, just mainly the beaches and accessible areas along the riverfronts and that. I mean, Kent has a coastline of 350 miles and there's over 50 beaches in Kent. I mean, obviously you've got the big ones like Viking Bay, Margate, Botany Bay, Westgate, Herne Bay. They're all the big well-known ones. It's even the small ones that I want to see as well. And some of my favourite ones are the small ones. Where they're quiet. I think there's three tidal pools around North Kent. There may be more. There's another way in now. That's the way you drive into the car park up there. There is a sign there which I didn't bother to read, so if I get a parking ticket, it's my own fault. I'll probably get back and it's permit only or something. That's a big old shell, isn't it? That's not a shell, that's a, oh, it's a dead stingray. Or, not stingray, sorry, just a ray. So I thought it was just bone, and I thought there's his tail there, but yeah, I went to turn it over, it was still all jelly. There's some quite big shells along here. All the seagulls are landing there, picking up all the worms. I know along here, I know just over there somewhere there's like a little cafe area. Don't know if it'll be open today. And beyond there there's toilets. I think there's a Indian restaurant up there as well. And I think there's like a beach sweet shack. I don't know if it's the same place for the coffee places as well. It's a bit waterlogged here, I might move up a bit. see how wide it is. I think it's, even though it's quite busy today, the beach is so wide, you don't technically have to get near anyone. I mean, I suppose it's a different story in the summer. I suppose it's quite busy all the way along there. I mean, I prefer a sandy beach if I'm going to sit on it, but then some people just can't do sand. There's another water outlet there, look. A bit too close to that in case it's sewage. Doesn't smell like sewage. Let's jump over. A few more people out there now, look. So from right where we started, right away along here, you can sort of see the rocks in the far distance. All that up there is parking. I'm not sure. I think that little building you can sort of see there. I'm sure that's like the sweetheart. There's horses riding along here, look. Ooh, let's get out of the way, okay, so run me down. It's all wet there, so I don't think they'll go through that. Sight you see every day, horses running along the beach. Unless you're watching some romantic movie. See them? You do that thing, you know, when you walk on the beach and when you're not looking where you're going, you turn on quite a big rock and you sort of slip off of it. I think your ankle's going to go at any minute. Maybe that's just me because I'm getting old. Guess we're up over there. This is where the Indian restaurant, I think the Indian restaurant's just that building you can see in front of you there with the sign. So I think it used to be a pub, not 100% sure. And I think that building in front of us, like I said, is where the coffee and sweet shack is, and there's quite a few people there, so it makes sense. When I come usually, I usually park up outside the houses, but I wanted to start the other end today. There's another horse on the beach just in front of me, look. There's some toilets here somewhere as well, but I'm not sure where they are. They're probably near that beach hut thing. Shack. So I hope you all had a good Christmas anyway. I'm looking forward to 2022. Hopefully it'll be better than the last couple of years we've had. I'm really looking forward to travelling again. However, I'm reluctant to book anywhere for this new variant, and they sort of 1 minute they're talking about lockdowns and not sort of meeting up again, and they're sort of stopping and going back and saying it's not as deadly, or I think this time it's more about people being off and not being out of work, so that's why there's not enough nurses, doctors, police, etc. Some music up there. Now if it's music coming from the cap or it's from that little helicopter thing. You know when they play music when people are riding. I still enjoy rollerblading. And here and sheer necks promenade. That's where I like to rollerblade. They're quite not wide promenades. Some horses in front of me, I'm going to go around them, I don't want to go too close to them. There's a little bit of a sweet hut there. Lots of people and their dogs. Not even music for an actual sweetheart playing. There's a horses. It's got a notification, I don't know if you heard that on my phone. The song that's playing is Blondie. The tide is high. No, it's not. It's got a bit busier now for a bit of the plunk to talk to himself with them horses running, look. Looks fun, doesn't it? I'd enjoy that. I can ride a horse, believe it or not. My dad and his partner own stables during the early 90s, late 80s. We used to go on the horses there. I can't remember where it was exactly. I know he had two lots. I think one was over towards past Sittingbourne Way. I'm not sure where, but I know there was one definitely up near Yawling Paddock Woodway. And then he did also have, I know the big stables he had when he lived up near St Albans. Can't remember, I was only young. But my dad's partner, she was quite a good horse rider. My dad could hot ride horses as well, but his partner, she used to do show jumping and gymkhanas and all that kind of stuff. It's a lot busier than this end. You can tell where sweets and coffee are. I made a good decision to come back because I'm sitting indoors, thought I must get out. So I decided to go and get coffee. I thought, well, while I'm out, I might as well go out a bit further afield. This is only 20 to 30 minutes drive from where I live, so it's technically just down the road. And it did feel good being out. And as much as I was a bit meh when I saw loads of people, actually quite nice seeing everyone getting out and enjoying themselves. And as you can see, everyone sort of keeps a sort of distance as well. There's a motor coming up, and I'll come back the other way. Well, we've got them, don't know if you can see on the camera, where the people's passing. Like one in outdoor gym equipment things. There's a couple of them there. There's one there, one a bit further along. They're good exercise walking along the beach. Of course, even when I get to the end and start the video, I've got to walk all the way back to my car. That's when I enjoy it. Not more, when I can just put the camera down and just look at things myself and throw stones like them guys are doing and probably sit up there somewhere, just relax and watch the world go by. Something So obviously I can't stop getting all the kids, but I don't want to do close-ups of them. I wouldn't like it if someone done it to my children. I made sure I wore leather trainers because I knew I'd probably get a bit dirty and wet, but some cases are a lot wetter than I thought they'd be. Just as you saw this morning, I put a video up. At the moment, just trying to get rid of a lot of the old footage I had, and there's not a lot of it's just plain, it's no talking. And it's just stuff that's interesting to see. I mean, today's was Hobson's Conduit in Cambridge, which is old, got good history. But I didn't talk much then. Try and talk a bit more now, but I'm not a history buff, so I don't know everything about everything, so I only know what I read beforehand. And sometimes you just come across places, so you don't know what they are when you're there. Try not to get these people. A lot more families on here now. Dad's playing a game I always play at the seaside. You get the stones and you pick some kind of post out in the water or a tyre in the water. As soon as the first person to hit it. Unless you're my son, he used to have a habit of doing that, but as his sister was looking in the water in front of him, she used to go crabbing. A short pause there, walking past the wall. Yeah, she used to look for crabs, and as she was in the rock pool, he used to come up behind her with stones and throw them, so they'd all splash at her. He's a bit older now, but I wouldn't put him past, he'd still do it. Is this in front of us? You can see there's the old beach huts. This is all still considered part of the beach. And there's the toilets up there, you can see them. See the three doors? Someone standing outside there. Sunlight's already dipping a bit now. Sort of there. It's 3:30 PM. It's still busy. Another pipe here or something, because the water all running down here. Yep, bit of wet. Take a couple of pictures. Picture of the toilet so people can see them, just in case they want to come and see the toilets. You know what I mean, so people know what to look out for if they come here. Not that many people probably watch. Usually I get a grand total of between 20 and 50 views on my videos, but let's do it to get out of the bat, and I like to document them. Then if I need to look at somewhere again, I can just go back. Although I must admit, it is interesting doing videos that I've done when I first started and going back to their place and seeing how they've changed. And even though it's only been coming up 10 years, I think, maybe around about that, it's amazing how things change. And because you're there every day and only see little things change at a time, you don't notice it until you look back. Like I was looking, I've done a couple of people watching in the high streets of various high streets around, mainly Medway. I'm just going back and seeing all the different shops that have gone. There's another pipe here, but it's all cracked, look. So it's all coming out everywhere. Step over it. See all the beach huts up there, look. Oh, I need to stop for a minute because I need to sort myself out. And I'm back. So I've moved up a bit because I've got fed up stepping over all them. Plus you can see the beach huts better. All the bright colours. It's a bit sandy, isn't it? There's not much further to go, you can sort of see in the distance. It does go round a bit, but I think it's sort of promenade ends and it's just like the sort of the grass and the trees going down towards where the beach is, and that'd be probably where I'll stop. It's very sandy here. Picture the huts. It's impossible to get a picture of the huts without people in front of them, because there's loads of people walking past. See, I don't like walking in the sand. You can see the them bars, I don't know if there used to be steps there or something. They're all the way along. Have a look at these bars, see what they are. Crunch, crunch, crunch. I don't think they're stairs. I don't know what they are. They go quite deep by the looks of it. Maybe there was a long, long time ago. Ooh. I had a quiet New Year last night. Didn't touch a drop of alcohol. So I feel really good today. I'm not a big drinker, to be honest. I go visiting different places. I like to pop in a pub in the evening just because there's nothing else to do. I mean, when you go away somewhere, you can film all day when you do the touristy thing. And even as an early evening, I like to walk around and see the statues and squares and that. But then after a certain time, sort of 8, 9-ish, there's not much you can really do. So I usually head to a local bar or pub, just have a quiet drink, download some of the footage that I've had. Not download it, but just sort of like put it on Instagram or Facebook. Don't know how long I've been walking for. See now the houses have all stopped and it's all grassy banks now, and that's sort of how it goes. But if you look on there, there's loads of people, so they obviously all walk on to the end and walk back. I don't think there's been too much wind today, so you should have been able to hear me. Although most of the time I've been whispering because there's been people around. Not whispering, but talking quietly. And with the crunching of the seashells, you might have missed a lot. So if you didn't hear it, hope you enjoyed the views. Yeah, I'm not going to go do the beaches in any particular order. It obviously depends on time and stuff like that. If I haven't got a lot of time, it's not worth me travelling down to South Kent. It's going to take me an hour and 20 minutes to get there. Well, probably an hour. Most places in Kent are an hour away. But it's an hour there, an hour back. And if it's a beach this long, I might not have time to do it before it gets dark. Obviously I've been in the summer, so I just play it by ear, and I don't know how often I'm going to upload them either. I mean, I don't want to be doing one a week, so as I said, I'm going to talk about stuff when I do it, and I don't think I have new stuff to talk about every week. Like I said, at the moment, because I'm not travelling, all I'm really doing is working and living normal day-to-day life of shopping and working, and that's it. Although, leading up to the Christmas period, I joined up with the Odeon Cinemas, $12.99 a month. Watch all the films you can watch. So I've been and watched The Matrix, The New Kingsman, Spider-Man, West Side Story. It's like when you've got that, because you don't feel like a new cost, you end up watching anything. I drew the line at Clifford the Big Red Dog doll. I wasn't going to sit there and watch that. Spider-Man was good. I really enjoyed that. Kingsman was very good as well. Matrix was good, but I hadn't seen the original one since it came out in, what was it, 99? So you sort of, as you watch it, you sort of have to remind yourself a lot of the things that were going on. If you just tried to watch that film on its own without knowing about the others, I think you'd be a bit lost, to be honest. West Side Story was okay. Certainly losing light quick, isn't it? Well, it does look nice, doesn't it? Look. That's where we come. Well, the beach huts are there, and we're way past them. And I had a coffee just before I come, and I might be visiting them toilets on the way back. But you watch now, my luck. Trying to go along to the end here and gone back. The toilet's probably shut. Little step up there. Yeah, I've got no excuse for my hiatus. Just sometimes real life comes first, and then I don't know, it's a combination of different things. Not being able to travel freely made me feel like I didn't want to upload stuff when I can see myself enjoying stuff and it's puddled with. Yeah, no, I can't use that as an excuse. It wasn't really just that. It was just a combination of working. Of course, with winter, you lose daylight quicker. And just sometimes, just uploading just takes so much time, and sometimes you just can't be bothered. I mean, even for big YouTubers that earn good money out of their videos, they've often complained about the upload, how long it takes to edit the videos and all that kind of stuff. Obviously I don't edit my videos nowhere near as professionally as they do theirs. It still takes time. And sometimes you sit there with all the intention of doing one and you just can't be bothered. It's nice light on the water, isn't it? Yeah, I know that sounds bad because obviously, you know, the whole thing of YouTube is to share your videos. But because it's only a fun hobby for me to do, I've got no upload schedule or nothing like that. But in the past, I said, yeah, I'm going to try and do this, this, and this. I can't keep to that. Because sometimes work in real life stops all that. I mean, at the moment now, like I said, one video came out today. Then I've got one in 2 days' time, another in 2 days' time. And I've sort of tried to space them out for Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And I'm trying to keep that going for as long as possible. Just to get rid of a lot of the footage that I've got, just taking up space. And like I said, some of them will be what you might consider super boring. Like I said, the one I put up today, Hobson's Conduit, it was a nice place to visit. But I don't talk on it. I even forgot to put music up on it. See the bird there, look, wading through. Yeah, and then there's a couple more coming. There's another one that's really short on there as well. It's only like a couple of minutes long. And I don't know why I didn't take more footage when I was there, because it was a nice building. I do know why. I'll put it in the description. It's because I was visiting two other places that I was actually going to. And I just found myself at this other place and took some quick videos of it. But I will return it. Chichester's on my list to go to. Because even though I've been to the cathedral, I want to do a more in-depth one. Dogs chasing stones. Oh, I didn't fall over. I didn't fall over, I slipped. Yes, I want to try and get as much of that footage done. I mean, all the places I went to in the last couple of years, and I've still got footage from every one of them to do. From Nice, Gothenburg, Nuremberg, Pisa, Faro, and then all the ones from England, Gloucestershire, Salisbury, Shrewsbury, Norwich, Cambridge, there's loads. And some of them are just, like I said, short videos. And when I wasn't putting out many videos, I felt bad. A lot of these pipes are broken, but I felt bad. I'm not going to tread on it and break it even more. I felt bad for not putting a video up for a couple of months and then just putting up a 1 or 2 minute quick thing. It felt bad. So I decided that I'm just going to try and get rid of this stuff. Like, where I put it all on my hard drive, it's all alphabetically listed in the places. So the first one I've done is from Cambridge. Then I think there's one from Canterbury, I think. Then Chichester. And what was the other one? Oh, Cornwall, is one from Cornwall. That's the one that I've done already. So I was going through my list, just picking up one from each area, just getting them down. And I probably will do a lot of the crappier ones. Sorry, crappier. It makes me sound like the videos are really terrible. The smaller ones are the ones that ain't got talking and not very interesting first. Just so I can get the bulk out of the way. And obviously, because they're shorter, they're easier to edit. So I can get them done quick. But I only decided to do these videos again. Boxing Day, I think I thought about it. And yeah, from Boxing Day till New Year's Eve, I managed to do 5 or 6. But it's where, obviously, I haven't been working that time, so it's whether I can keep up pumping them out like that up until I get rid of them all. But there's various reasons I want to get them off. One, it's taking up space. Or flow, anyway. Yeah, one, it's taking up space. Two, some of the videos are getting so old now. Like one that's coming out in the next couple of days, the place is shut down now, so you can't even go there if you wanted to. Yeah, and just getting them out. Maybe it's the end, but most of these pictures all look the same, didn't they? This look nicer. See what I mean about the hills behind us now? It's just grasslands. Let's get some books. Amazing what you find on beaches. Obviously round the corner you've got the old, well, I say round the corner, but round that way you've got the old bunkers and that there. Yeah, plus I think there's some over in Sheerness as well. I think the ones that way are the ones that are falling into the water, and the ones back at Sheerness are the ones that are standing, but you can't get very close to them because it's in that, you know where the fault is? And it's all dock lands, all there. We'll walk a little bit further along here because it's still technically a beach here. I come here last year when they lifted the COVID restrictions and it was summer, it was really nice and I wanted to go to a beach. So I knew this beach wasn't that packed and we went right along the end there. Because obviously then we were still told to keep away from other people. Along this way it was packed. There's people just not on top of each other but too close, I would say. So we come along here, took a picnic, sat there with some music, only about 4 or 5 hours, just relaxing the sun, enjoying watermelons and other goodies. There's loads of, see, these are obviously kind of some kind of building. So, I don't know if there used to be buildings here or if it's just dumped here to build the beach up. There's loads of big bits, look. It's like the old mill ring things. I won't go too much further because obviously when I get back before it's dark, I don't know what the times are for the car park are. That's it's like a slope or something. I forget what beach I went on to. There was a beach I went somewhere, I think it was in up at Haitian. And when I was building the beach up there, they knocked some houses down there. Bits of the old houses there, you can see all bits of like lintels from the doors and bricks where there was stuff on them before, like either glass or wallpaper or something with door numbers on them and that. It's quite interesting seeing it all. I'm looking forward to doing the beaches of Kent because, like I said, there's some really nice ones. I love Botany Bay because I love the chalk arches and that. Yeah, thick sludge of mud there. And then you've got things like Viking Bay, which is probably one of the most famous ones of Kent's beaches. And you've got things like Margate Beach, which is lovely, ginormous sandy beach. But I can't say I enjoy that beach over the last 10-20 years, just the kind of people that's on it now. So I've been there and seen fights taking place and drunkenness and drug dealing, not drug dealing, but drug taking. It's not the kind of place you want to go if you've got kids with you, which is a shame because it's a lovely big beach. But see where that bit there looks like where the grounds come away a little while ago, eroded. We walked to there and we'll end it. Come quite a way. see the huts in the distance, just over there, and we're miles past there. Good for the health. Again, that's why I wanted to do this. It wasn't just doing videos, it was getting out, fresh air, exercise, all things that are good for you and needed, especially the first day of the year as well. There's been many years I've been too ill, not really ill, but just not wanting to get out the next day. Not only that, not getting up till like midday or 1 o'clock after the night before. I don't know if it's just getting older, but I'm just not into the alcohol that much no more. Well, I said this was going to be a walk and talk. I've not really had much to talk about. Can't really think what I could have said. And some of you might have even muted me and just looked at the views. A picture of the seaweed. I was trying to get the tyre in it though, eh? Oh, just sunk. This is a bit sludgy around here. There's more bits of building here that not what it used to be part of. So it's all sort of smoothed off, so it's been eroded by the water. Oh, that was me tripping. And next time I go somewhere, I think I should check the car park for parking times and costs and that, and not just drive in and assume everything's free and going to be open for hours. Excuse me. Well, we might stop here actually, because I don't really want to wait for all this. I don't know what it is. I don't know if this is where the mud's falling. You can see that mud's really fresh. And that's what it looks like. It looks like all the mud that's come off of there is all sludged up here. Yeah, it is all mud, thick mud. Oh, and it's... Because obviously the mud retains water. It's really sludgy. You can see how wet it is. See, if I'm getting round this, you can see where it's eroded. You can see all the grass on the rest of it and nothing on there. I don't know if these trees come down with it, will it come? Yeah, look, you can see a big pile here, look. You can see it all. Yeah, as far as I'm going to go, there's not much more you can do along there anyway. And I'm a bit worried about the parking situation. So, I might get another video out of this about me camping in a car overnight. Or me visiting a local pound to get my cup. I've just completely sunk and got my trainer went about 3 inches into the mud. I'm not happy. I should have gone across there. Look at my poor trainers. Can't really see it there, can you? I know it don't look bad, but to me that's bad. I like to keep my trainers clean. Definitely some wetness went in as well. Anyway guys, that was it for Minster Leas. Hope you enjoyed the walk and talk. I will do more of these in the future, but I don't know on what kind of schedule. Like I said, there's over 50 beaches of Kent, So even if I've done 1 a month, it's going to take me 5 years to get around them all. So it might be quicker than 1 a month, but don't hold me to that. Depends on my upload schedule. Even here, you can see it's all come down, but yeah, I've got quite a long walk back. And as you can see, dusk setting in. Yeah, so because of the upload schedule, because I want to get them other videos done, and I am hoping to go away again in February. I'm going to skip January. I'm hoping to go away again in February, so of course that'll be another load of stuff. When I go away, I usually get anywhere between 10 and 20 videos of things I'll go and see. Obviously, I only go away the Friday to the Sunday, but that's 3 days that I'm constantly on the go looking at stuff. So there's a lot of videos that come from just one trip. Of course, when it's somewhere far afield, like when I went abroad to Europe, I want to see as much in that little bit of time as I possibly can, because I never know if I'm going to return to these places. Like when I went to Pisa, I wanted to see everything I could see in Pisa. The Nice trip, I don't think there's many videos of that, partly because it was my first trip abroad doing it on my own, and I didn't really plan it well, so I didn't go to that many places. And also, the hard drive I put all the stuff on got corrupt, so I lost loads. To this day, that was 2.5 years ago I went there, I think. And I'm still to this day trying to rescue it off of this hard drive. I'm slowly managing it. But we'll just see how it goes. I'm not making no commitments. I'm not going to say that 3 videos I've put out for the next couple of weeks are going to stay like that. I'm not saying I'm going to be doing a beach video every week or every month. We'll just see how it goes. This channel is not really this kind of channel that a lot of people will follow and watch every video, because it's such a big range. I mean, it's not just historic buildings, it's not just beaches, it's a bit of everything. So someone might want to see the beaches of Kent, but don't want to see places abroad, and vice versa. People might want to see places that I go abroad, but don't want to see things in Kent, which is up to them. I mean, I watch everything. I watch YouTubers from Essex and Sussex and all over the country. I just like to see everything, because if it's somewhere really interesting, when I go to that area, I know what to look for. Right, anyway guys, this is the walk back now. So you've seen all this. Let's take a picture of the last couple of pictures. Yeah, so hope you enjoyed it. I will see you whenever I decide to do a new one. Obviously I'm going to try and get a lot of them other videos up. And this video, I will try and get up in the next couple of days. Depends what the upload schedule's like that I've already saved. I'm sure I've got something out for the rest of this week, every other day. So I might squeeze it on one of the other days, or I might save it for next week. We'll see. Anyway guys, take care. Happy New Year. Let's hope for a better 2022. Little extra bit guys, I know I said I was going. I thought I'd show you up on the promenade how wide it is. And there's benches all the way along, as you can see. Look how busy it still is. It's gone full. It's like a dog walking on the wall. It's quite wide. If I remember when I get along, I'll show you a close up of the beach huts and of the shop and that, if they're not too busy. Might not be that steady, guys. Here's all the beach huts anyway. All these benches have got memorials on them as well. Every single one of them has got some plaque on it. And those are flowers. Look at all the colourful beach huts as well. So we're not the last beach hut now. I didn't realise how far we walked. That blue light you can see ahead of us, I think that's where the helicopter is, where the sweetheart is. And my car's way past that. and it is probably 4:15. I hope that car park doesn't shut early. I'll show you the sweet shop as I go past, if it's not too busy. There's a close up of the toilets. A bit blurry. Christmas light's still up. I'll still show you the cafe area, but they've just turned all the lights off, so you won't see it open. There's this gym equipment all the way along. There's a player up there. I don't know if that's the Indian restaurant or if it's a pub. I'm sure that's the pub that's now an Indian restaurant. I'm not sure. I'm not walking up to find out either. That's the shut sweet shop. Still probably got 10-15 minute walk to my car. So I was not shut. That was definitely a pub in the corner or something over there because I can hear live music. Oh, someone's playing live music out their van. It's amazing how many people sit out now. All the way along this beach, it's saying signs of that award-winning beach. We've got them stairs in front of us. I'm walking along that bit. I know my car's not too far along from there. That's a car, it's loud music. There's a pub or something over there. No, I don't want to go that way because that's the road sign. What's that helicopter? That's like a sweet shop. I thought it was a ride, I don't think it is. I think it's a mobility scooter done up with a helicopter. All the cars have to go slow around them. Right in the middle of the road. Bless you. Right guys, see this little path in front of us here? I think that leads you up into the bank where the cars are. There's still some cars up there, so I'm hoping there's no gates. Oh, this is the Indian cuisine. The other one was a pub. The player is obviously still a pub because that's the Indian cuisine there. The white horse. Right, so if we take up this dirt track, that brings you up onto that bank that I said about earlier where my car was parked. And I see other vehicles out there, so I'm hoping that's a good sign, unless we're all locked in together. I was so stupid, I didn't look at any restrictions or permits or... The thing is, mine's further along than that, there's two paths. And there's hardly any cars along there. But we'll soon see. Anyway guys, this really is the end. The other little bits were extras. I thought I'd show you a close-up of the beach huts and the toilets and the promenade. But this is definitely finished now. Our cars are still going down the van, because that's a good sign. Yeah, so this is definitely the end there. So for me, at Minster Leas on the Isle of Sheppy, the first of the beach walk videos. You all have a good 2022. Hopefully I'll see you more frequently than I have been last year. And let's hope we can get back to travelling, sightseeing, all the other fun stuff we like to do this year. Take care guys, happy new year. Back again, just some good news guys. Bad news is the toilets were shut. I'm dying for a toilet. I've got 30 minutes to go. Good news is the ramp's still open. On the sign it did say £3 parking per the meter. I didn't see a meter anywhere. I've looked at other cars, no one's got parking tickets or parking parking tickets or parking fine. So that's definitely it. Look how nice the sky looks. That's definitely it, guys. I'm back to my car now. All ready to go home. Take care.
Don't mind your blind lies. I got your sign, so.